answers are made, I would like to see, you know, okay, here's the answers, and then as a board, even if it's 4-1 or 3-2, vote on whether this is, should be the response, because, you know, I still have an issue with, you know, the whole variance, you know, thing being the preeminent thing, and of course, so I would hate to see that representative of my view without a chance to voice dissent to that view.
Well, I can tell you that my brief simply, I've got them started, I don't have them finished, they're due on Monday, which is, we've got a time issue. I can tell you that what I'm telling the court is that the plan we adopted fits the parameters. Obviously, we didn't adopt a plan with, but we did adopt a plan with lowest variance, but I don't think that was the sole driving force, and I'm not arguing in the brief that that's the sole driving force. I think that's the preeminent purpose of the statute. I think the statute says that, the court cases say that, but I'm not making an argument that we had to adopt that plan. Basically, I'm saying that the court review should include only looking at the plan we adopted and determining whether or not it comports with the statute.
Right. I mean, I have no problem with that. The plan certainly does comply. Yeah. Otherwise, I don't think any of us would have voted for it. So, in my opinion, it complies. I just, you know, I've always hesitated, just like don't sign a blank form. I hate to just, you know, authors say, yes, we're going to go ahead and say this without knowing what's going to be said.
And I understand that, too, yeah. But I'm wondering if we can accomplish that just in the minutes or as part of the motion.
I would hope we can accomplish it in the minutes. There is nothing in the statute that says
that's what I was looking for.
Representation.
Yes. Is that in the briefs that have been filed
no.
too? So it doesn't even merit mentioning that.
It does not.
Okay.
Great.
No, it's Market Township brief to put a name on. Does a very credible job of saying you shouldn't split the township because it dilutes the voting power of our township. I think. Dan, your comment was that if we were splitting something, that one maybe made sense because the area we combined with the city was very much like the city.
Yeah, I mean, I've been making the argument all the way through that, you know, my objection to, you know, you folks as far as not splitting anything, saying splitting this is no, as long as the communities are, you know, homogenous, it was not an issue for me.
Mm-hmm. And that's... and I believe the court will honor that.
There's a reason those parameters are there and these are allowed.
Yeah. And in terms of splitting precincts, that requires what is called a population count. And the court really doesn't like that. And the reason they don't like it, the reason that the statute has us follow political boundaries is it makes it harder for us to gerrymander. If, you know, if you got a boundary, you got...
There's a reason that boundary's there.
Yeah, and it makes it harder for us to manipulate. Once I start carving up non-census tract data, and I go into the city of Marquette, and I split their precincts, and I do actual count, figure out where all the students live, and you know, do that kind of manipulation. Or if we were in an area that had a minority population that was concentrated, split it up so that they're not able to elect a representative. So the courts really frown on splitting the census tracts up.
Or the Marquette Township. And the question is, are you more fairly represented by having one person represent the whole unit of government or having many? And I think the issue is, the judgment is divided on that in a very individual one because the city of Marquette has several people who represent them in the new plan and as the president. Some feel that's diluted, some would feel that's access. And so I think that that's why representation is not on the table as an issue.